Lindsey Jacobellis. I'm in snowboard cross and just won the snowboard cross mixed teams event.
Here we go.
Am I holding it up as we're
doing it? No, just look down yourself.
Uh-oh.
So just hold it down.
48, you said?
Yeah, 148.
148. Well, I was pretty excited that I had an opportunity to go far right. I really liked that gate, and especially with this start section, it was so technical and flow, and the timing was so important. I almost didn't want to see people as much. Normally, I like seeing riders in front of me because it almost lights my fire and makes me work harder. But in this, I didn't want to be overeager and kind of go too hard too soon. So we did hold out in the gate for a while, but I was really happy with matching the transitions and really generating speed. And I was super excited going over the first jump, going into the first turn, because it hit me then this could happen, because I don't always win the whole shot, and it's certainly a lot easier to win when you're out ahead and you don't have to deal with traffic.
Beat me.
It definitely hit me hard in the exact moment that I crossed the line. And then, you know, all those times that I maybe doubted myself or was in just a slump or wasn't feeling great, because, you know, with my body, it comes in cycles. And, you know, my knees could hurt some days, or I'm not feeling as fast or as strong or as peppy. And this course, this combo, who knows, the alignment of the stars, whatever you want to call it, it just kind of came together for me. I had moments that I'd freak out, even on the day of or in between heats. And, you know, instead of me keeping that to myself, part of my training with my mental coach would to be voice those concerns and voice those emotions to my support staff, whether it was, you know, teammates, family back home, friends back home, my coach, PT, you know, the doctor that, you know, fixed my elbow just a few months ago was up there as well. And it's just nice to have that soundboard immediately right there to help just kind of like change that downward spiral into an upward spiral. You know, I moved to California about 10 years ago, but I was just kind of renting and going back and forth. But the last 4 or 5 years now, I've actually, you know, bought a place and set up like my own like little hub that I could have and have my dog with me, and then get into a routine that I could break away from the cold world, like in snowboarding, the cold weather, and then come back and have guaranteed warmth and sunshine, and just feels like my bones don't hurt when I'm sitting on the beach.